Hello, I am Caroline Gonzalez, and today I would like to discuss amino acid digestibility in heated soybean meal fed to growing pigs. This study was conducted by Gonzalez, Kim, and Stein in the University of Illinois. Contents: first, an introduction. Second, the objective. Third, the materials and methods. After that, the results and the discussion, and finally, the conclusion. Soybean meal has different antinutritional factors. Some of them are the trypsin inhibitors. These can reduce the performance in pigs. However, some studies showed that heat treatment can reduce their concentration in soybean meal. But at the same time, the heat can affect the concentration and the digestibility of amino acids. The amino acid most affected is lysine by Maillard reaction. However, development of Maillard reaction depends on the water activity, temperature, pH, time of heating, and the type and availability of the reactants. Therefore, amino acid digestibility can be impaired with the heat treatments. For this reason, the objective of this study is to measure the effects of heat treatment of soybean meal on apparent and standardized ileal digestibility of amino acid by growing pigs. The materials and methods that we used for this study were 10 growing barrows with initial body weight 25.3 kilograms with the standard deviation 2.15. The treatments were 5 different diets. 4 of them were with soybean meal and the same formulation. However, each soybean meal had different heat treatment. The first diet was the control, which had no heat treatment. The other ones were heated at the same temperature, 125 degrees Celsius. However, 2 of them were autoclaved for different times. One was for 15 minutes and the other one was at 30 minutes. The other soybean meal diet was oven dried for 30 minutes. Autoclaving and oven drying are heat treatments, but they had different properties. Autoclaving involves moisture, pressure, and heat, and oven drying involves just thermal treatment, whose function is to remove moisture by heating. The last diet was nitrogen-free diet for estimating basal endogenous losses. The pigs were fed at 3 times the maintenance energy requirement and the diets were changed according to the period. The pigs had free access to water. The sample collection were done each period. Each period was 7 days long and the collection was done on 6th and 7th day for 8 hours. This table shows the chemical composition of soybean meal after heat treatment. The content of crude protein were similar between diets. However, the concentration of the lysine and cysteine in autoclaved soybean meal were decreased. The content of the other amino acid was not affected. The ingredient composition of the 4 soybean meal diets had the same formulation. The soybean meal was included at 40% and was the only protein source. The nitrogen-free diet did not contain protein. The chemical composition of the experimental diets showed that the crude protein and amino acid content were similar between soybean meal diets. However, the lysine content was reduced in autoclaved soybean meal. Now, I would like to show you the results and the discussion present in this study. In this table, we can see the results in apparent ileal digestibility of crude protein and amino acids in soybean meal subjected to different thermal treatments. The crude protein and amino acid digestibility were linearly decreased at the time of autoclave, increased from 0 to 30 minutes. The greatest reduction were observed for lysine and aspartic acid. However, the apparent ileal digestibility for most amino acids were numerically reduced in oven-dried soybean meal compared with the control, but was not significantly different. The standardized ileal digestibility of crude protein and amino acid showed a linear decrease in autoclave soybean meal when the time was increased. The greatest reduction were found in lysine and aspartic acid. However, the standardized ileal digestibility in oven-dried soybean meal was numerically decreased compared with the control diet, but it was not significantly different. The reduction of apparent ileal digestibility and standardized ileal digestibility of crude protein and amino acid observed in autoclave soybean meal diets is in agreement with other studies realized by Mugan and Rutherford in 1996 and Martinez and Mesquad et al. 2007. The reduction of the amino acid digestibility may be due to cross-linkage established between lysine and other amino acid and polypeptide chains during advanced Maillard reaction, which reduce the efficiency of proteolytic enzymes. Most affected was lysine. Maillard reactions involving the amino group of lysine and the carbonyl group of reducing sugars caused a reduction in the digestibility of lysine. The color differences observed between the four soybean meal diets may be due to the melanoidins formed during Maillard reactions. Samples were darker the longer they were autoclaved. However, the oven-dried soybean meal had no difference with the color of the control diet. This may be because the moisture content in oven-dried soybean meal was too low for developing Maillard reaction. In conclusion, heat treatment with moisture and pressure impaired the apparent ileal digestibility and standardized ileal digestibility of amino acids in soybean meal. Furthermore, increasing the time on autoclaving decreased the digestibility of all amino acids. Thank you for your attention. If you would like more information about monogastric nutrition research, visit our website. Thank you again and have a good day.